Both the Xenomorphs and Necromorphs are two alien races, both specifically designed to be an invasive species, made to destroy and consume any and all life unlucky enough to stumble upon them. The Xenomorphs, by their insect-like parasitic reproductive cycle, and the Necromorphs, by their markers changing their victims on a cellular level. In this video, we'll try and answer the question of, would the markers from Dead Space work on the Xenomorphs from Alien? The way the markers work begins with a black marker. These are a helix-shaped monolith with a black colouration and covered in runes meant to be deciphered by an intelligent species. They are created by the highest known necromorph type, a Brethren Moon. When the Brethren Moons make more of their kind, they will produce and send out a black marker housed inside an asteroid and send it through space towards a suitable planet which harbours life. The black marker that landed on Earth landed in the Gulf of Mexico 65 million years ago and wiped out the dinosaurs. Once it has landed and detected life on the planet, the black marker will begin to emit a signal targeting the species with the most potential to evolve intelligence. This signal will begin to alter the organism's genetic makeup, guiding it on an evolutionary path towards higher intelligence. Over millions of years of evolution, once the targeted species has achieved sapience, they will be inclined to reproduce at a rapid rate and also to industrialize. Eventually, the species will reach a point where they exhaust their home planet's natural resources and reach the population limit the planet can sustain, forcing them to venture outward towards space. Once they've reached this point, the black marker will emit an electromagnetic energy, making itself known to the now spacefaring species and posing as a source of unlimited energy. The black marker would contain a set of instructions on how to replicate it, so that multiples could be constructed and spread to all other worlds colonized by the host species. This serves two purposes. Firstly, to spread the marker's influence as far as possible, and secondly, to make any attempt at taking quarantine measures impossible. These reverse-engineered copies of the original marker are known as the red markers. Once the red markers were constructed and spread to all their territories, they would emit their own signal, which would induce psychosis, dementia, and hallucinations, causing the people to go crazy and kill either themselves or others. The frequency would then begin to change necrotic tissue into necromorph tissue, creating a fast-spreading plague of grotesque monsters known as necromorphs, which will in turn attack the rest of the population, creating even more death, which creates even more necromorphs. Once a large enough amount of organic matter became infected, a convergence event would initiate, where the black marker would send out a huge burst of energy, pulling all necromorphs into it along with amounts of the planet's crust, forming a new Brethren Moon, which would then repeat the process. The Xenomorphs are an animalistic species first created using the black goo, a pathogen made by the engineers as a terraforming agent and/or bioweapon, which breaks down organic matter and repurposes it. A rogue android named David acquired a stockpile of the substance and experimented with it, creating the Xenomorph species. This incredibly hardy and predatory species would be seen as the perfect organism in the eyes of androids such as David and Ash. The life cycle of the Xenomorph begins with the ovomorph, or egg, which contains a facehugger. The facehugger latches onto a host animal's face and deposits a chestburster, which bursts out of the victim, killing them, and matures into an adult Xenomorph. A royal strain xenomorph known as a Praetorian will grow into a queen, which lays more eggs, completing the life cycle. If a way isn't found to defeat a xenomorph hive, they will quickly overrun whole planets and end any and all other life. So if a marker were to be in proximity to a xenomorph hive, could it turn the aliens into necromorphs themselves? A xeno-necromorph is an interesting idea to think about, especially what forms they could take. But would there be anything to prevent the marker's signal from turning the xenomorphs? You could say that the necromorphs we see are made from dead humans, so does that mean the signal only works on humans? Well, the answer to this would be no, as in Dead Space 3, on Tau Volantis, we learn of another race which fell victim to the Marker's influence, an aquatic sentient species known as either the Tau Volantians or simply the Tau Volantis aliens. In the game, we even see Necromorph versions of this species, proving the signal can affect anything and isn't specific to humans. Another argument would be that with Xenomorphs having acidic blood, would any sort of pathogen like a bacteria or virus even be able to survive inside it without being instantly dissolved before it even has a chance to alter its cells? Well, the answer to this is that the Necromorph infection, despite being often referred to as such, isn't actually a physical infection at all, and is rather an electromagnetic signal which changes the host tissue into Necromorph tissue. So yes, they physically would be able to transform a Xenomorph into a Necromorph. But the question isn't really a matter of could a Marker transform a Xenomorph, but rather would it transform a Xenomorph? As Markers are known to specifically target a species which is sapient enough to be spacefaring and need resources, so I would say that no, a Marker wouldn't transform Xenomorphs, as they wouldn't be intelligent enough to build more Markers, so the Brethren Moons wouldn't be interested in them. Although, as stated earlier, once a black Marker lands on a planet, it starts to turn the smartest species present into an industrialised one, and Xenomorphs are highly intelligent, especially higher forms such as queens, but in an animalistic way like apes or dolphins. So I do think that a black Marker would start to turn Xenomorphs into a fully self-aware species over millennia through evolution, which is a weird picture, a Xenomorph with human-like intelligence, but it has been explored in some of the comics like the White Hybrid and that synthetic that was built to look like a Xenomorph. So in conclusion, I believe a Marker wouldn't directly turn Xenomorphs into Necromorphs, but since they are smart for animals, I do think the Marker would make them evolve to become self-aware and build spaceships like they did with humans and the Tau Volantis aliens. Come to think of it, as the Xenomorphs do reproduce at a faster rate than any ecosystem can handle, they already meet half the criteria. I hope you enjoyed this theory video and found it interesting. If so, make sure you remember to leave a thumbs up rating on it, as that helps out a lot with the algorithm. The better the videos perform, the more I'll be able to make. Also, if you want to see who wins when a Xenomorph and a Necromorph fight, I have a versus battle video on that which I'll have on screen for you here. And if you want to see more Dead Space content, I'll have my playlist containing all those videos here. Also, please consider leaving a super thanks or becoming a member to help the channel directly. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.